To be an icon is a very special permission, especially for video game characters, because you're not only a quick buck, you basically define who the company is.
But more times than not, they find the mascot of their true company, well, kind of.
Crash Bandicoot, the Wumpa Fruit Eating Wacko.
And Sonic the Hedgehog, the fast freedom fighter of Green Hill Zone.
Ah, Sonic. You know, the man. You know, the myth. You know,
the slickery speedster.
Enough of the you-knows, my god.
Yeah, CJ, everyone knows who Sonic is.
You're not my dad, Shadow Man.
Anyways, for this battle, we'll be relying on the game, meaning no things such as the Archie comics or cartoons.
I'll be talking about the Bandicoot, and as for my friend...
I'll be talking about the... Hedgehog.
Aw, why does your animal's name sound better than mine? Jokes aside, let's go to the Green Hill Zones and see what our blue little friend has in store for us.
Dr. Ivor Robotnik is an evil man wanting to take over the world.
Pingus.
Yeah. So we gathered an army of animals, transforming them into robots and mechs to take over the world! However, a blue figure didn't only come to the call, he ran to it.
Wow, a prickly hamster. How scary.
At least people knew what hedgehogs were before Sonic.
I'll give you this. They are adorable little buggers. Oh, look at him.
But anyway, Sonic the Hedgehog, the Blue Burr of Green Hills, Sonic, hero-wise, is most known for saving little creatures from Robotnik's clutches. But trust me when I say, he can do so much more.
Alright, I'm listening. Let's see what Dash Boy has for us.
With pleasure, mi amigo.
Sonic is a pretty powerful guy for, well, you know, a hedgehog. First of all, he can fight on par with people like Knuckles, and can even take hits from him, and Knuckles is able to cause earthquakes and easily shatters boulders with his fist alone, but that's just one of his normal feats. He took down Perfect Chaos, who could level an entire city, fought people such as Shadow, Metal Sonic, the Deadly Six, Infinity, he's even gone toe-to-toe with Mario, which may or may not be canon, even if they would. Just sports games. But even if he doesn't scale to the plumber, that doesn't mean he's weak. In fact, he can do a few more cooler things than Mario without even popping a shroom. He can spin dash, which is basically him turning into a little ball and rolling around. Trust me when I say, it's a lot more threatened than it sounds. He can roll and blitz or target enemies while airborne. I know this because CJ keeps spamming this move in Super Smash Bros.
You're just jealous of my 90s running skill.
Sonic can double up, heal, or increase his strength, make sound waves out of his spin attacks, run up walls, a super punch, a meteor kick, and took down giant mechs in mere seconds. And then we have Sonic's weapons, such as his boxes. One gives him an ability of dashing foes with a spicy fire attack, and another is an electronic box that electrocutes pretty much anything. Unfortunately, these two boxes are weak to water. However, the bubble shield, which helps Sonic bounce and breathe underwater, and the sprinkling shield is an invincible star ripoff that insta-kills any enemies in his way. He also has a car, a sword known as Caliburn, and shoes that can help him go to FTL speeds in his spin dash form, run underwater, and jump higher.
Hey, speaking of all that light speed junk, how fast is Sonic anyway? I'm kind of curious.
I'm glad you asked. Sonic can outrun or outmaneuver almost any kind of firearms. He can easily dodge missiles, beat everyone he's ever met in a race. He can keep up with Wisp, who can fly to a planet in outer space in seconds. And possibly most impressive of all is him outrunning a black hole. Now, of course, we all know he can't buff this feat up too much, because Sonic only outran it for half a minute before it sucked him up and knocked him out. And the black hole itself took its time swallowing an amusement pod. But this feat, along with others, put Sonic at a pretty consistent sub-relativistic to supersonic speed. Get it?
Okay. I'll admit, that's pretty impressive. But nothing my boy Crash can't handle.
Hey, buckle your seatbelt, because it's about to get a whole lot worse for you, my friend. So Sonic has these little guys called Wisp, right? Basically, after he touches a certain Wisp, he gains a cool power such as turning into lasers, fireballs, lightning drills, and then he can even turn Sonic into a black hole and, well, whatever this thing is. So, yeah, Sonic's pretty powerful. But we haven't now. It's the moment we've all been waiting for. You see, after a dire situation, Sonic can summon 7 gems, known as the Chaos Emeralds. But these things are pretty useful, even before going super. They give you the abilities to heal, stop time, bring people back to life, teleport, and most impressively, they were even once used to put the Earth back together once. But I know you want me to cut the chit-chat and get to Super Sonic, so here we go. Super Sonic is a powered-up Sonic with FTL speed. He can fly, is near invincible, and can basically do the aforementioned abilities of the Chaos Emeralds. But after adding the giant Master Emerald, he can gain even more power by becoming Hypersonic. An even more powerful version of Supersonic. He's faster, stronger, and you bet more durable. In this form, he was able to create a star and take down gods with the help of Silver and Shadow.
Yeah, Sonic's the chat of the story, but we also can't forget his flaws. First of all his powerful attacks have time limits, especially Supersonic, who can't even stay a minute without a steady supply of rings. And Sonic himself is also cocky, impatient, immature, and sometimes all out just a butthole. And all those water abilities and water weapons he has is for his defense of his fear of water, not being able to swim and all. And even though Sonic is obviously really fast, he can't seem to catch up to every situation coming at his way at a time, and he can also seemingly get overwhelmed.
Even with all these imperfections, Sonic is still one of the most iconic game characters and heroes of all time. Don't trifle with the fastest thing alive.
Somewhere in the Wampa Islands, there lives a creature who loves going on adventures with his crazy cartoon pals.
Rayman?
Shut up.
Now, believe it or not, Crash wasn't always the powerhouse we know him as today. He was... get this. He was a normal bandicoot. Okay. I'm sorry. Anyway.
This brainiac, going by the name of Neo Cortex, wanted to take over the world. And he decided to do it with his armies of animals and robots, as well as minions, of course. The respectful minions they are. But then, he needed a head leader for them all. So he decided to mutate Crash. But then, after the zap, something crazy happened. Something legendary.
You say legendary. I say ridiculously luckied and fry into a piece of meat!
Boy. After his successful escape, Crash knew he had to go back to rescue his girlfriend, who is... attractive.
Shimp.
Long story short, he got the girl, saved the island, and now he's Cortex's enemy for many years to come.
Oh, please. Crash shaves that bland Donkey Kong Country Island. Sonic shaves the world several times.
Oh no, my friend. What have I told you that this bandicoot has saved dimensions?
You have my interest.
Before I tell you all about that, let me tell you what he can do first, eh?
Alright, let's see what he's got.
First and foremost, let's talk about Crash's moveset. While in that little machine of Cortexes, he seemed to have gained a significant physical upgrade. He can double jump, slide kick, use his body as a weapon, and yeet objects into the air with enough pressure to shatter them. But his most recognizable attack is his spinning attack, or his cyclone spin, as some people call it. Unfortunately, after doing this move, he will be left dizzy, but that's okay, because during a certain game, he gains a significant upgrade that allows him to spin as long as he wants.
The Shy Clone, you say?
Yes. And for one of his weapons, he has a bazooka that shoots out Wampa Fruit.
Fruit. You've wasted my time talking about a super strong and fast hedgehog just to match him with an opponent that shoots... fruit?
Hey, don't you dare underestimate my boy and his fruit, especially since he has a mech variation.
Okay, that's kind of cool how Crash and Alien crossed over like that.
Oh my god. He also has a jetpack allowing him more airtime, obviously, a helicopter, a motorcycle that can travel on land and space, a surfboard, a yo-yo that he fiddles around with sometimes when facing enemies, and Mecha Bandicoot, originally created by Cortex, now on Crash's side. It's a giant mech that Crash can control. Now that we have his arsenal out of the way, let's talk about his incredible feats. First of all, Crash can scale to and even defeat his adopted brother Crunch, who was able to have natural disaster-like abilities once. He's also defeated several of Cortex's mechs and minions with nothing but his bare fist, as well as can lift and even throw rocks up to 8 tons. He also casually and almost pretty much daily destroys crates with his bare fist, and usually gets a yummy Wampa treat out of it. But now, we talk about probably the best thing that Crash has, his durability and regeneration. He could survive being crushed, shot, electrocuted, turned into ash. He also survived an explosion to the face with enough power to destroy an ice crater. He can resist black holes. And probably the most impressive of all is when he survived a crash landing orbiting to Earth in one of Cortex's ships. This on its own is a multi-city level feat. But if Crash feels like he can't take the pain, that's alright, because he always has his companion Aku Aku on his side to help out.
It's Squidward's Tiki Land. I love that episode.
Why must you torment me?
Aku Aku can do all sorts of things for Crash. Create force fields around him, shoot lasers, teleport Crash to certain places, even turn Crash invincible for a few seconds. He also has telekinetic abilities and can turn Crash invisible. Not that Crash needs that because he has a box that turns him invisible. Also, as well as a TNT box that he can throw at his foes. Not that he'll need Aku to tank many hits for him, cause he's quite the quick guy. He can dodge lasers, bullets, race around explosions, and even dodge lightning. This makes him somewhere around supersonic to subreal.
I'll admit that stuff's pretty impressive, but not enough to beat the Blue Blur.
Oh, don't you worry, my friend. I'm not done yet.
Really? What else can a dum-dum like Crash have?
Dum-dum? I
am offended. Crash is able to outsmart several of Cortex's minions, as well as Cortex himself, as well as other smart beings around his dimension. And he can learn how to drive or pilot something just by being around it. And even created a formation of travel by himself. But I digress. Let's talk about his most powerful ability. The Quantum Mask. With these masks, he can slow down time, phase objects in and out of existence, and turn his own gravity all sorts of places. Heck, one even upgrades his original spinning attack.
Right, you keep buffing up Crash, but let's forget, despite his neat intelligence, he can still be easily tricked and used, and he can still be overwhelmed by big foes and weapons. He also gets scared when they look more tough or stronger than him.
I suppose those are just prices to pay for being a super strong bandicoot. Don't mess with the PlayStation's top star.
That isn't Spyro.
And with all the research over and done with, I think we're both ready for these two quick fuzzy creatures to face it off. Will Crash slow down Sonic?
Or will Sonic crash the competition?
Let's find out. Only one life for both. And no cheating.
My mommy always told me that cheating was bad.
That was almost too easy!
Laser!
And the winner is... Sonic!
Boom, baby!
I accept my fate. Kind of actually saw Sonic winning at some time. But at least it was really close.
Right you are, my friend. These two turned the tables on us a lot of times, but eventually, we both settled on Sonic winning. But why is that?
First, we looked at base forms, and surprisingly, with his stronger weaponry as well as his stronger self, Crash may have seemed like he could have taken Sonic down. That is, if he could have catched Sonic.
Both reaction speed-wise were pretty equal, but it really isn't surprising that Sonic is faster. And despite Crash having the better weaponry, battle-wise, that doesn't mean Sonic's weapons are useless, and Sonic could just blitz through most of Crash's weapons. Crash has his position that takes you somewhere else, while Sonic has the Chaos Emeralds, which are best known for taking you somewhere else. What's that, a mech? As in, mech Sonic deals with daily?
I think you can see where we're going at this point. And it just gets a whole lot worse for Crash when we describe the supersonic in the room. Aku Aku and the Quantum Mask actually make it equal, respectfully. But Crash himself is going to slip up at one point, and there's no doubt about that.
For experience, Sonic took it. His advantages outweigh Crash's pretty hard, and I mean, come on, bro. There was a time where he met his young 90s self. And as for intelligence, to be honest, it was pretty hard to decide. Because both do outsmart geniuses, Crash having the tech intelligence of Sonic, well... he has common sense, and he's not insane.
So yeah, while Crash had strength, weaponry, and durability, and regeneration, and he can do some pretty neat things himself, as well as his tools in Aku Aku and the Quantum Mask, eventually, Sonic just overwhelms him with all his abilities and weaponry.
Well, even if Sonic won, I still see Crash as a pretty good character.
Yeah, and I do have to admit, Sonic ain't that bad of a meme either. And with that said, the winner is Sonic the Hedgehog.
I don't read that part. I don't read the shelf and shit part.
But what about Crash's... What? No, frick. Hold on. But what about Crash... But... But what about Crash's constant stomach pain after going to Taco Bell?
Yeah, CJ, everyone knows who Sonic is.
Alright, let me drink some milk. I don't get paid enough for this.
Crash and... you know, we missed quite a lot throughout these years. A Monokuma and Freddy Fazbear rap battle came out before we could do that battle.